for our flex and stretch routine. This is one that I had done, I think it was about 3 weeks ago, and lots of members just emailed me, called, said how much they appreciated this particular routine, so I figured we would try it again. There are a few items that you're going to want today to do the routine, if you have them. If you don't, you can improvise with a couple different things. You're going to want a bandana, or a scarf, maybe a kitchen tea towel, something that you can just kind of fold over and make nice and taut. A hand towel would work as well. Then, you also want weights, if you have them. Again, we've joked about soup cans, water bottles, whatever you have just to provide a little bit of resistance. And the third thing that you're going to want today is a pillow. It's nice if it's kind of a smaller size, and if it's not too terrible soft, if it's more of a firm pillow, that would be handy. Again, if you don't have it, I think we're just going to use the pillow for one thing, so you can always sit that one out. This routine, again, is called flex and stretch. So it is stretching with a little bit of strength training included. We're going to start off just by getting present, kind of sitting nice and tall in a chair, preferably one without arms. Take a couple deep breaths right here. Whenever you inhale, you want to breathe in through the nose. Exhale is out through the mouth. Let's take three deep breaths. Breathing in and out. In and out. One more. Good. Let's start off with our neck now. We're going to do chin to shoulder. Again, I like to sit towards the front of my chair for most of the routine, sitting nice and tall. I'll remind you that a couple times throughout the routine. Chin to shoulder, taking your chin over towards your right shoulder. Coming to center, chin over to the left shoulder, and center. One. For most of these exercises today, we'll do 15. That's two. Three. Right. Center. Left, four, right, center, left, five. And if you want a little more of a challenge, try to peek over your shoulder as if you're looking behind you. Seven. Right, center, left, 14. One more. Right, center, left, 15. Very good. Now, ear to shoulder. Taking the right ear and dropping it towards your right shoulder. Coming up to center. Left ear towards the left shoulder. One. Right. Always find that center. Left. Two. Right. Center. Left. Three. my shoulder up towards my ear. Six. Right. Center. Left. Seven. Eight. Nine. Right. Center. Left. Ten. Your neck should be feeling pretty loose by now. Last one. Right. Center. Left. 15. We're going to combine those two moves for a neck roll. And we're just going to do 5 of those today. Again, this is your exercise, so whatever feels best to you. As always, you can sit a particular exercise out and join in again later. And you can always add more reps to this as well if you prefer. Or if you want to do less, again, you know you. Do what's best for you. We're going to try 5 neck rolls, taking the chin down to the chest, rocking the left ear over towards the left shoulder, looking up to the sky, right ear towards the right shoulder, and chin to chest. 1. Looking up, right ear to the right shoulder, chin to chest. 2. Left ear to the left shoulder. 3. 4. One more. Left ear to the left shoulder, look up at the sky, right ear to the right shoulder, and chin to chest. That's 5. Bringing your head up, sitting nice and tall. Let's move on to our shoulders. We'll do 15 shoulder rolls forward, and then we'll do 15 shoulder rolls back. If you haven't joined in before, we make that a couple different moves. So the first part, we're going to shrug up and then go front and down. 1, shrug up, push front and down, making really dramatic shoulder rolls forward. 3, 4, 5, up, front and down. 6. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, one more, that's 15. What we do one way, we do the other. So taking it back for 15, shrugging up, push back, and down. Really open up that chest. Up, back, and down. 2. 3. 4. 13, 14, and that's 15. Let's try 5 trunk turns. Sitting nice and tall, hands on your hips. Again, this is when it's nice that we don't have arms on our chair. Hands on our hips again. We're gonna twist our upper body over to the right, peeking over your shoulder. Come to center, take it to the left, twisting that upper body left, peek over the shoulder, and center. One. Two. Right. Center. Left. Three. Four. That's 5. Good. Let's move onto our arms. Again, still nice and tall in that chair. We're going to start off with arm circles. Taking your right arm straight out to the side. Depending on your range of motion, you can also do out in front if that feels better for you. We're just gonna make circles one way and then the other, keeping our arm nice and straight. I'm gonna go out to the side. Going forward first and then we'll take it back. 15 arm circles. And keep them kind of nice and tight. They don't have to be anything big. Just kind of nice circles. Let's try 15 front. For 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Backwards now. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take that right hand up to your head and hold. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and release that. Now we're going to do arm circles with the left arm, straight out to the side, or again, you can do in front. Going one way and then the other. Let's start forward. For 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Back it up. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, left hand up to your head and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release. Ding, ding, ding. Let's enter the boxing arena. So still sitting nice and tall, gentle fist. Gonna punch across to the right, straightening out your arm, then to the left. Throw a couple punches. Let's go for 15. 4, right, left, 5, right, left, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, that's 15. Very good. Moving on to the weights. So if you have them, now's the time to grab your weights. And if you want to put them in your lap, we're actually going to start with our hands. So have your your weights available. We're going to jump right into them then. Let's wiggle your fingers a little bit. Open and close your hands. We just had gentle fist. Let's extend the fingers now. Wiggle the fingers. All right. Now for this one, with your hands open, you're going to want to take the thumb to the tip of your pinky. So you'll have nice ovals or circles. And then the thumb to the tip of the ring finger. Middle. Index. Walk it out. Middle. Ring. Pinky. You're just walking the thumb across the tip of each finger. Trying to keep nice ovals or circles. As you do it, working your way in. And back out. Good. Shake your hands out a little. The weights. Starting out with wrist turns. Both arms extended out in front, about shoulder height. Just gonna simply turn the weights over and back in. Trying for 15. 14, one more, 15, good. Drop your elbows at your side. Okay, we're gonna do some arm curls. Elbows are at your side, palms are facing up. Just gonna lift those weights up to the shoulders. Drop them all the way back down so they're nice and straight beside you. Curling back up again, 2, 3, we're still sitting nice and tall, 4, 5, again we want to do these with control, 6, gently lowering down, and coming back up to shoulders, 7, 8, one more, up, and back down with control, 15, good. Now we're going to take our arms up, so starting with your weights at shoulder height, remember, you want to keep breathing in through the nose, out through the mouth, having that nice rotation, getting oxygen everywhere that it needs to be, good blood flow. Again, weights are at shoulder height. We're taking the weights straight up, parallel, and back down to shoulder height. Up, try to reach up too. Extend yourself as much as you can. 3, 4, this isn't about speed. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Let's let our arms hang at our sides a little bit. We're going to move into cross-country skiing, or we'll pretend that we're cross-country skiing. Now, I like to say for this one, if it's better for your back, again, keeping everything nice and open, but you can lean forward a little bit. I know I usually prefer that, and it feels a little better for me. A weight in each hand. You just want your arms hanging at your side. You're going to pretend like you were skiing, keeping your arms nice and straight and swinging them opposite each other. Just back and forth. Maybe we're at 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Good. I think I had a couple crashes. The weight kept hitting my chair to get better at driving those skis. And this next one, a lot of people said in particular that they liked this one. It's a couple of steps. So sitting nice and tall, weights together, directly in front of you, starting towards your chest. You're going to push out, open wide, close, and come back into that starting position. That was one. We're going to try 15, open, close, and in. Two, out, open, close, in. Three. Good. Four. Nice and controlled. And notice sometimes it's a little more difficult the slower you try to do it. Really working those muscles. Six. Seven, eight, nine, ten. We're getting there. Keep breathing. 11. Out, open, close, in. 14, last one out, open, close, 15. Take a couple deep breaths after that one. Let your arms relax a bit. Breathing in through the nose and out through your mouth. Hand. This one we're kind of going to be bending at our waist and taking it diagonal down in front of us as if we were picking something up off the floor. As always, this is to your comfort level. If you just want to take it down to your knee, maybe to your ankle or the floor, whatever suits you, but you do want to make sure that you come up nice and tall then. We're going to drop the right weight as low as you feel comfortable going. Come all the way up to a nice tall seated position, and then the left weight goes down. One. Center. Left. Two. Right. Center. Left. Three. Trying for 15. Four, I want to see those faces when you come up. 13. Too. Do I go back or front now? Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Gentle leans, not jerking my body in any direction. Six, just kind of letting it fall from side to side. Seven, eight. Maybe you can take it a little deeper each time. 13. 14. for 15. Bring that scarf down. Very good. Toe touches. We're going to stay seated for these. Still with your scarf. And I call it toe touches, but maybe for you, it's a knee touch. Maybe an ankle touch. Or maybe you can get down to your toes and then come all the way up. So we're just going to go as low as you can go and then coming up so that I can see your face. If you were here, we'll pretend. Stretching down, bending at the waist, coming up nice and tall. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, you're doing great, 12, 13, 14, that's 15, great. Rowing now. This is to work our core a bit. Again, if you slid back in your chair, you definitely want to be at the front of your chair for this one. We're going to pretend as if we're rowing. So with the scarf, you want to keep your, again, back nice and straight. You're just going to lean straight forward, extending as far as you can, and then leaning back, and now you're not going to touch that chair. You're going to be tempted to, but engage those core muscles. To keep yourself, you're going to lean back just before the chair, and then take it front again. Three. Four. Five. Six. Again, taking it as far front as you can. Seven. Nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, this last one, let's hold back, engaging that core. Hold for five, four, three, two, one. And coming up to center. Good. Let's take a breath after that one. A good breath, two or three. Breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. Done with the scarf, tea towel, whatever. If you want to set that to the side, somewhere where it's going to be out of the way, we're going to move on to our lower body now. Still some seated things, and I'll let you scooch back in your chair so that your back is against the back of the chair, just for some support for you there. Starting out with our ankles. Right leg extended out in front of you. Just going to do some ankle rolls. So drawing small circles with your feet. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Still with the right foot, but reverse it. So maybe counterclockwise. 14, 15. You can drop the right leg, lifting the left leg out in front of you. Ankle rolls, just tiny circles with your foot. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Reverse that. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower the left leg down. Now we're going to step on the gas pedal. We're warming up our lower body because in just a bit we will do some standing exercises. So we want to make sure that everything's awake and ready to go when we are. But for the gas pedals, lifting both legs up in front of you, you're going to point your toes out and then pull them back. Push out and pull back, just like you're stepping on a gas pedal. 4, 5, out, back, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Lower your legs down. We can come again to the front of the chair. I know we're always going front and back, front and back. We're going to do, keeping our knee bent, a little bit of side stepping. With the right leg bent, you're just going to step out to the side and bring it back in. Step out and back in. 3, depends how wide you want to go. 4, 5, whatever's comfortable for you. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. That's 15, but take it to the left now, keeping that knee bent. You want to step out to the side and back in. Out and together. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Back to our feet and our ankles. You can slide back in the chair again if you want. It helps me a little bit. Just extra support underneath your legs. Both legs out in front. Again, if you just want to lift them just slightly up off the ground, that's up to you. I just prefer to get them up a little bit more. And I think it might help you see it too. We're going to bring our toes together and then the heels together. So toes are together, then your heels together. That's 2, 3, toes, heels, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Drop the feet down. Let's take a couple deep breaths before we move on to the standing exercises. Nice deep breaths. Get that breathing under control before we try to stand up. exercises. It is important to note that each of these standing exercises can be done from a seated position. So if it's more comfortable for you, or depending on your abilities right now at this present time, you can stay seated or stand with me, whichever you prefer. We're going to start off by marching in place. Again, I like to just come around my chair, kind of have the back there, just to support. Marching in place, or if you want to hover, that's fine too. Get your exercise. You do what's best for you. Just marching in place, bringing those feet up off the ground. Can be just a little up off the ground. Maybe you really want to bring those knees up. Again, your exercise, you decide. Just marching in place for a little bit. I'm going to bring that to a stop. Side kicks. All of the weight is going to be on my left leg, left side. My right leg is just going to swing out to the side and drop back down. It's up to you how high you want to go. 14, and 15. We're going to switch it up. I'm going to kind of come out front a little bit more. So you can watch my left leg swing out to the side. All of the weight is on the right leg. The left leg goes out to the side and back down. Again, if you have a chair or something you want to hold on to. 3, 4, seven, eight, nine, a chair, maybe a countertop nearby just to stabilize yourself if you need it. Or just hover. Again, like I said, it's always good to kind of hover. That way you know it's there if it comes time that you need it. Hopefully you don't. We're going to do the one foot in front of the other balance test that we did before. You can always stand on one leg if you prefer. But we're going to start with the right foot directly in front of the left foot. One foot in front of the other in a straight line. We're going to stand nice and tall, finding a point ahead of you to stare at, if that helps you. We're just going to hold that. Again, hovering if you need to. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and gently release that. Now we're going to have the left foot take the lead. Left foot directly in front of right foot. Nice straight line. Standing tall. Finding that point to look at. And hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Gently release that. Calf raises now. So this is basically what we were doing. So if you're sitting, you're going to kind of redo the same one. The gas pedals that we did before, where we pressed out and then pulled back. We're going to do that now, except standing if you are. If you're seated, go ahead and do the gas pedals again. But still standing. We're going to come up onto our tiptoes and then down. 2, 3. I was almost getting ahead of myself there. 4, 5. 6, up, flat foot, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. This last one, let's hold up on your tiptoes for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lower back down. Adding in an extra challenge there for you. And you can try that too. Add that in if you do it again. Try and hold it a little bit each time. Now we're going to rock back on our heels. Again, hovering over something or holding on as needed. You want your tiptoes to be up in the air. Back on your heels. 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, last one, 15. Very good. Let's go ahead and have a seat again. Not, don't sit down yet. Go ahead and grab your pillow before you sit down. What you want to do with the pillow is place it between your knees. If it's rectangle, you want it kind of nice and tall. Between your knees, sitting nice and tall. Again, it helps if the pillow is fairly firm rather than have too much give. You just want to push your knees together and then back out to where they were. So that it's your legs that are holding that pillow, pushing in and out. Pushing those knees together. 3, 4, 5. Really pushing them in. 6, 7, 8, 9, 13, 14, and 15. Good. We can toss the pillow off to the side. Again, make sure it's somewhere safe out of the way that you won't fall on it once we get back up. So make sure that you put it somewhere out of the way. And we're gonna start our cool down. So sitting at the edge of your chair, nice and tall, taking a couple of deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth. Starting our cool down. Some of these are exercises or stretches that we did at the very beginning. So we'll do trunk turns, 5 of them. Hands on our hips. Again, twisting that upper body to the right, looking over your shoulder. Coming to center. Now twisting to the left. 1, right. Center, left, 2, right, center, left, 3, right, center, left, 4, 1 more, right, center, left, and 5, very good. A couple shoulder rolls, let's do 3 forward and 3 back, shrugging up, push front and down, 1, up, front and down, take it nice and slow. This is our cool down. 3, 4, and 5. Now back for 5. Shrug up, push back and down, really opening that chest. Back and down. 2, 3, 4, one more. And 5. Let's take our chin over to our right shoulder and hold that for 10 seconds. Chin over to the shoulder and hold 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Center. Chin over to the left shoulder and hold 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, 1, center. 3 deep breaths with me. On the inhale, we'll lift our arms up. On the exhale, go ahead and lower your arms down. Nice deep breaths, breathing in and out. And 3. Thank you so much, everyone. I'm glad you tuned in. Again, Desiree Myers from the Washington County Senior Center. Thank you so much. And we will have a routine next week, Tuesday, 3 o'clock, same time, same place. I hope to see you.